Item hash, SCP-1201 Object Class, Euclid Special Containment Procedures. A 50 meters perimeter around Area 1201 is to be maintained at all times. Testing into the nature of SCP-1201-2 is to be done promptly and without hindrance to the route of SCP-1201-2 to prevent a possible containment breach of SCP-1201-3. Any change in behavior by SCP-1201-2 is to be immediately reported to the site director and the area is to be put on lockdown. Changes in containment procedures are currently being drafted as of the incident outlined in Document 1201-C. Description: SCP-1201 is a shallow wall fountain located in Damascus, Syria. The fountain itself displays no anomalous properties save for its use by SCP-1201-2. Although SCP-1201-2 appears to enter SCP-1201 during separate manifestations, entrance by Foundation personnel does not seem to be possible. An investigation is currently underway to confirm whether or not the placement of the well is purely coincidental. SCP-1201-2 appears to be a large, completely hairless chimpanzee similar in size to an average adult human male. Strength and agility exhibited by SCP-1201-2 is not considered to be abnormal relative to its size. The entity materializes within 40-48 meters of SCP-1201 each year on / at 23, 23 and 46 seconds with severe injuries including third-degree burns, severed limbs, deformities consistent with exposure to trifluoric acid, and holes scattered around the body. SCP-1201-2 regenerates in the space of 12.3 seconds before attempting to return to SCP-1201. An outline of a typical occurrence can be found in Document 1201-A. Attempts to halt the progress of SCP-1201-2 toward SCP-1201 have been effectively unsuccessful, as the entity appears to assault researchers when coerced, and prolonged confinement of the entity seems to produce an adverse effect originating near SCP-1201. SCP-1201-2 is not hostile toward researchers during its manifestations but will actively attempt to remove or disable barriers between it and SCP-1201. SCP-1201-2 appears to be highly vulnerable to electrical shock but further attempts to halt the progress of SCP-1201 are not recommended due to events outlined in Document 1201-B. Document 1201-A, Events of //2002, Area 1201 Forward. 5th recorded incidents and observation of the manifestation of SCP-1201-2. The entity was questioned alongside researchers keeping pace with the movement of the entity on a pre-constructed motion track. The entity was visible for 20 seconds before disappearing into SCP-1201. SCP-1201-2 manifests 47 meters from SCP-1201. Subject appears heavily bruised around the torso and face, with third-degree burns covering the body. SCP-1201-2 appears to regenerate to typical appearance in the space of 12.3 seconds before righting itself and sprinting toward SCP-1201. Agent Breen attempts communication. SCP-1201-2, the hell do you guys want? Agent Breen, what are you doing? SCP-1201-2, going to meet Beth. Agent Breen, who is Beth? SCP-1201-2, a real bitch. Agent Breen, what is Beth? SCP-1201-2, a bitch. Agent Breen, thank you for your cooperation. SCP-1201-2 disappears into SCP-1201. In log document 1201-B, events of //1999, area 1201 forward, second recorded incidents and observation of the manifestation of SCP-1201-2. The entity was temporarily disabled with a prefabricated electric field after regenerating. The entity was incapacitated for 18 seconds before power to the grid was removed by Agent Sanders and SCP-1201-2 was released. Agent Sanders, you're going to want to cooperate with us. SCP-1201-2, the fuck is your problem? SCP-1201-2 attempts to break from the electrical current but is not successful. Agent Sanders, we're going to need some information before you go anywhere. SCP-1201-2, not telling you shit. SCP-1201 begins shaking, and partially fractures from its foundation. A long, smooth, black mass with the appearance of a tongue, which will henceforth be referred to as SCP-1201-3, can be seen partially probing from SCP-1201. The tongue stretches in length over 40 meters toward Agent Sanders. Agent Sanders terminates the power to the containment on SCP-1201-2. SCP-1201-2 rights itself and collides with the appendage of SCP-1201-3, making contact and crashing into a wall. Flames begin to funnel out from the mouth of SCP-1201 and SCP-1201-2 is severely burned. SCP-1201-2 is pulled into the air by SCP-1201-3. SCP-1201-2, you bitch. SCP-1201-2 has the tip of the appendage in a headlock, 20 meters above ground. SCP-1201-2 begins tearing into the skin of the appendage with its teeth. SCP-1201-3 falls to the ground with SCP-1201-2. Flames begin to increase in volume from the mouth of SCP-1201. Temperature in the immediate area increases by 20 degrees Celsius. SCP-1201-2, still in possession of the end of SCP-1201-3, dives into the mouth of SCP-1201. In log document 1201C, events of //2003, area 1201 forward, 6 recorded incidents and observation of the manifestation of SCP-1201-2. The entity was questioned alongside researchers keeping pace with the movement of the entity on a pre-constructed motion track. The entity was visible for 21 seconds before disappearing into SCP-1201. SCP-1201-2 manifests 49 meters from SCP-1201. Subject appears with a large hole in its torso. SCP-1201-2 appears to regenerate to typical appearance in the space of 12.3 seconds before righting itself and sprinting toward SCP-1201. Agent Breen attempts communication. SCP-1201-2, you guys are persistent. Agent Breen, please tell us what you're doing. SCP-1201-2, fine, fine. Since you're so fucking adamant about it. This has been going on for quite some time. Beth just doesn't know when to give up. I'm trying to teach it who the real King of Candyland is. Agent Breen, you're being facetious. SCP-1201 jumps into the air, maintaining momentum while delivering a kick to Agent Breen's head. Agent Breen's head is severed and explodes on impact with a nearby wall. SCP-1201-2, you're ruining the fun. SCP-1201-2 disappears into SCP-1201. End log.